If you haven't already, hit that like button and subscribe and turn on post notifications so you don't miss any of our future videos.
Aloha, my keto friends. It's Maria. Let's try this again. I'm here on my paddleboard watching for whales, and I thought that I would do a little live video talking to you about constipation on the keto diet while I watch for the whales. Hopefully we'll all have a great encounter. So let's talk about constipation on the ketogenic diet. Not a lot of people want to talk about their poo, but some people really suffer from constipation, and sadly, they go to the doctor and the doctor gives them Miralax. Come on, people. Miralax is just putting a band-aid on the problem. You're not figuring out what is really going on. And you want to figure out what's going on, people. You don't want to take Miralax for a long time. Do not use smooth move tea. Smooth move tea is very harmful to the intestines, and it's going to cause you to be addicted to those and need those all the time. Don't use smooth move tea, okay? What you want to do, let's look at the problem. There's a couple reasons that constipation can be happening. Number one, nobody wants to give these up. Dairy and nuts. Dairy and nuts are constipating. I'm talking about butter, cheese, cream cheese, sour cream, things that people are living off of on the ketogenic diet. This is why I have 5 books that are completely dairy and nut free, because dairy and nuts hold people back from weight loss. They cause constipation. They cause acid reflux. They cause diverticulitis, Crohn's. There's autoimmune issues. We tend to be so free about giving up gluten on the ketogenic diet, but we don't want to address dairy being an issue. And sadly, it is. Dairy can cause miscarriages for women when they're trying to get pregnant. So it's a common allergen. If it's fine for you, that's great. But if you are constipated, I would try to give up dairy and nuts. Number two is lack of salt. The colon needs a lot of salt. It does not need fiber. If you think about babies, they go poo all the time. They don't have any fiber, right? But they do need salt. When babies get constipated, sadly, doctors will recommend prune juice, when in reality, if they just added some salt to the baby's diet, the baby will no longer be constipated. Prune juice is just sugar, you know, and that sugar is going to retain water. And this is why constipation happens when people start the keto diet, because when you do keto, along goes a lot of water loss, because all of the carbohydrates that retain the water are letting it go. And this is that 5 to 10 pounds that people see that they lost on the scale within like a day, and they're like, yay, I lost 10 pounds. Well, it's just pitting edema. You just lost a lot of water loss. I had a client who was local, and she would lose 20 pounds in a day when she would do the diet, and she'd gain 20 pounds in a day when she fell off the wagon. It wasn't that she gained 20 pounds of fat. It was pitting edema. It was water loss and water gain going up and down, up and down. It's good when you lose the water loss, however, because it's going to help with blood pressure and releasing of the fat. However, if you lose too much water, you're going to get constipated, you're going to get headaches, you're going to be tired. And so you can't just drink more water, because guess what? You're just going to pee a lot more. You need to add in salt. The colon needs salt. It doesn't need fiber. I just want to keep telling you that. There's a great book called The Fiber Menace, talking about how fiber is actually like steel wool to the intestines, and it causes things like diverticulitis, Crohn's, colitis. It's not good. So what you need to do is think about your salt intake. And I usually recommend, when people start the keto diet, put aside 2.5 teaspoons of salt by your cooking vessel. And if you don't use that in a day when you're cooking, I want you to add it to some water, just enough so it's not salty. You could add electrolytes. Like Redmond has an electrolyte mix, Element has an electrolyte mix. You want to look for good quality electrolyte mixes, because some of them, they'll have magnesium citrate or magnesium oxide. Stay away from those. I'll have good quality ones linked below. Those are the ones you want to try. Otherwise, you could just be a minimalist. I have a recipe for soul water. It's just basically adding salt to water and drinking a little bit of that throughout the day. It will really help with energy and constipation. If you're taking an iron, let's talk a little bit about salt. When you, why do we need so much salt attention on the keto diet? This is why. When you're getting rid of breads and pasta and rice, there's a lot of salt and sodium in those products. And even a McDonald's milkshake has more sodium than their French fry does. Because salt is a flavor enhancer. It's added to everything. It's added to desserts. There's so much sodium in all these packaged foods. And that's why if you do a proper keto diet without these packaged food items, not only are you gonna see much more success, you're gonna need to be more cognizant about salting your food, because eggs don't come with salt. Steak doesn't come with salt. You need to have a heavy hand of salt and you're gonna feel much, much better, okay? Especially when people are intermittent fasting or doing OMAD, you're probably not getting enough salt in a day. So you have to either do an electrolyte or add some salt to water. Another thing that can cause constipation are iron supplements. Now, if you're low in iron, I have some better suggestions for you, which I'll have in the blog post on Maria Mind Body Health if you are low in iron, because iron supplements usually just cause constipation. And again, stop putting a Band-Aid on it. Why are you low in iron? Are you low in iron because you don't eat red meat? Are you low in iron because you have a gut absorption issue? Are you low in iron because you have heavy menstrual cycles? Like, let's figure out the problem and fix that so we're not low in iron anymore. Because when you're low in iron, you have less fat oxidation, you have low energy, you usually have sleep issues. It's a big problem. Let me see, what else can cause constipation? Just low hydration in general, not drinking enough liquids with salt. So, you know, get your hydration on. I have out in the sea, I have my big drink. Don't drink from plastic, people, you know that, right? But anyway, those are some of my tips for constipation on the ketogenic diet. And I'd love for you to comment here below or on my YouTube on what I should talk about next when I'm waiting for the whales. Whales are pretty wild. You know that whales, they come here to mate and have their babies, and they don't eat anything the whole time they're here because the water is just too clear. There's nothing for them to eat. They fast for months on end, and they wait till they get back up to Alaska to feast, and they do the bubble netting, which I have yet to see. I only see them fast here and have their babies, which is pretty miraculous. Anyway, that's for today, my friends. Mahalo. If you want to change your life like I've changed mine with food, I would be honored to help you. Many of you don't know that I was twice my size. I had acid reflux. I had PCOS, which is polycystic ovarian syndrome. I had depression. I had IBS, which is irritable bowel syndrome. And food changed my life. And not only did that happen, I get to eat good food, right? Good food. So if you want to eat good food, have perfected meal plans made by me and personal help with supplements or modifications. If you have Hashimoto's, if you have Graves, if you have IBS, if you have PCOS, contact me. I would be honored to help you. You can go to keto-adapted.com and find a lot of different options there for personalized help, or message me by commenting below on this YouTube video, or you can check me out at mariamindbodyhealth.com. Mahalo.
Sharing is caring. Share this video with your friends.